Hello everyone, my name is Kelton Levy with Roadware Incorporated, and today we're going to talk about estimating concrete mender for making repairs to cracks and spalls. It can be tricky sometimes to figure out how many cartridges or how many gallons of concrete mender you're going to need to make a repair in a crack or a spall when you're adding two parts sand to one part liquid or three parts sand to one part liquid, and it gets kind of complicated. So we made an estimating program on our website that shows you how to figure all this out, and this is how it works. So here we are at the Roadware website at concretemender.com, and you can see over here, if we scroll on down on the left-hand side, it says Roadware Estimator. We click on that. That brings us to the Roadware Estimator page. Pretty simple, right? And it's just a form we fill out, and let's say our project, we're going to call it demo today. And so let's see, what's going to be the length of our crack? We measure out a crack, it's about 150 feet. So we'll say it's 150 feet. And the depth of the crack, I'm gonna say it's 1 inch today. And the width of the crack, average width of the crack, we're gonna say is 1/2 inch, all right? So that gives us our basic dimensions laying out our crack. And down here, we're gonna select our sand ratio. Now the default is 2:1. That's what we use with most concrete mender repairs, is two parts sand to one part liquid to give us the amount of concrete repair product that we can make. And actually, sometimes we go 1:1, sometimes we go 3:1, or even no sand, depending on the product. But with concrete mender today, we're gonna go two parts sand, one part liquid, and that's a 40-30 grit manufactured sand. And to make this repair, to fill this crack, it's gonna take 900 cubic inches of material. And so that's gonna mean we're gonna need 3.9 gallons of concrete mender mixed with sand to make the repair. That can be either done in gallons or in cartridges. And we list it out right here. So it's going to take 1.76 gallons of concrete mender before adding the sand, or it's going to take about 11 cartridges of concrete mender, 600 milliliter cartridges, before adding the sand. And then we're going to add about 46.82 or 47, let's say, pounds of sand. That's going to give us our 3.9 gallons total yield to make the repair. So far, so good. That's how you figure out on a crack or a spall or a joint. Let's say we're going to do a spall. So a spall, we could say, is maybe 3 feet by 2 feet by 2 inches thick. That's a good size spall. Let's figure out how that's going to take, how much product that'll take. So our length is going to be 3 feet, and our depth is going to be 2 inches, and our width is going to be 24 inches. We got to convert that to inches now because that's how it's set up. We're going to keep our sand ratio 2:1. So now it's going to take 1,728 cubic inches of repair material to fill that big spall. That's 7.48 gallons, or it's going to take 3.37 gallons of concrete mender before adding the sand, or 21 cartridges. So as you can see, a little bit of concrete mender, you know, goes a long way. If you mix 1 gallon of concrete mender and 2 gallons of silica sand together, you get about 2.2 gallons of repair material. So, you know, like I said, it extends pretty well with the sand in it. With this repair in the spall, it's going to take about 90 pounds of sand, and that's going to give us our 7.48 gallons yield of concrete mender repair material. Further down on the page here, we just have more information on how to calculate out different things. We have a little video here. It shows that if you, one part liquid concrete mender, you add the sand to it, see how much it expands up and becomes good solid repair material. And we have a little chart here, and we also have a picture of actually what 40-30 silica sand manufactured sand looks like. And we'd be surprised if a lot of people really haven't seen that before. It's a nice manufactured, clean, dry sand. It's hard. It's about the size of table salt, I would say. But there's different gradations, different things they call it around the country. So if you have any questions or have any doubt, just give us a call, and we'll be happy to work that out with you. You can also use, you know, manufactured quartz or colored quartz, or there's many, many different things you can put in concrete mender. As long as it's generally free of dust and hard and a dry material, we can use that to make a good, you know, polymer concrete repair. So that's called the Roadware Estimator. It's on our website at concretemender.com. It'll help you figure out how much concrete mender you're going to need to repair a crack or a spall or a joint or anything else you happen to be doing. Just punch in the numbers and they'll tell you what you need. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time at the Roadware YouTube channel. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, put some questions down below. We love to get those. And also, we love it if you subscribe to our channel. So thanks, and we'll see you next time.